And a lot of my leads are... A day doesn't go by that I don't pick them up and play some of this kind of stuff.
This is Tuffy. The reason it's Tuffy is it got hit by a beer can right there. Oklahoma City.
You know, I had all this great foundation. First gig I had was at the 90th floor in Dallas, a jazz club, when I was 12. They said, Stevie, come on up and play some guitar. You know? I backed up lots of people. They'd show up and they wouldn't have a band. So Chuck Berry would call up, and I don't know how many times he backed me up, 10, 12 times, something like that. Ideas of licks, you know, Chuck. Ideas just interweave and pretty soon you're making up new stuff.
How much did country music play in shaping your musical vision?
We grew up loving country music and gospel music and blues and jazz. That stuff was going on in my house all the time. So, you know, Dance all night long.
Dance all night long.
Well, come on, darling, don't you look that way? Don't you know when you smile, I got to say, you're my honey looking lover, you're my heart's in life.
By early 76, it was finished. I was quite pleased with it. It was a record that I wanted to make, you know, and I produced it, and I was in control of it. I had two slides, the front cover and the back cover, and the tape, and I went down to Capitol and went up to the president's office and said, well, I finished my record, and here's the cover, and here's the back, and here's the record, and I think you'll be very pleased with it. It's going to do really well. And we got together with the art director, put it together that day, you know, and I left town and waited to see what was going to happen. You know, the beauty of it was in Fly Like an Eagle came out, Take the Money and Run was the first single. And it was right up into the top 10 and people were going, no, it's the wrong single, you know. And it was just, you know, being played all over the country and going, boy, this is great. Oh, you mean you want the right single? That was Rockin' Me, which was the next one. And then that went to number one. And so what was really great was, like, we became kings of, like, the establishment top 40 radio that, you know, that Johnny Mathis and Fabian had been the kings of or something, you know. And we weren't allowed to even, you know, they wouldn't touch us with a 10-foot pole, and all of a sudden, ha, 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 we're number one, you're playing us. We are what you are now. And at the same time, the underground FM stations were coming up and getting stronger and bigger and stronger and bigger. And by this time, they were really a real force in the market. They were a big part of our concert deal. Every time I toured, I'd go visit an FM radio station after a concert and play records till 4 in the morning, everyone in the United States, you know. It was really obvious that Gary and Lonnie and I had a really great rapport. We were quite happy with what we were doing, and said, well, let's put the band together. You know, let's see what we can do. And we put together a small tour. We went from the small theaters to the arenas, and then we were playing football stadiums. all of a sudden, instead of making a couple thousand bucks a night for five guys traveling and living in a motel, you know, there was money left over to like go, well, let's see if we can't get some bigger lights. And, you know, let's clean up the sound a little bit. And can't we improve this monitor system? And you have to understand, these were the first concerts that were ever done in a football stadium. And I mean, it was an immense challenge just to get a PA system that would work and that could be focused on 70,000 people and make it sound good.
Living in the street. Oh Lord, there's a solution.
And so we worked with a lot of sound companies and developed staging, and I went to Disney and got some lighting people there and started working on rear projection things and working on our production. And we got into our laser phase where we carried a great big huge water-cooled laser, which this was about the size of this table, and set it up behind the drums, and had to have like 50 gallons of water running over it a minute, you know. This was before there were laws regulating lasers, so we could do anything we wanted to with the lasers. And we used to put mirrors all over a football stadium up in the top of the light posts and stuff and do giant sculptures over the audience.
Yeah, and there were, you know, screw-ups.
I stepped on my pedal to hit turn on the laser, and they hit the dry ice machine, and pressure had been building since like 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and the entire stage was engulfed in dry ice. And I got vertigo. I almost fell over, and I was afraid it was gonna freeze my lungs. And the hose broke loose. There was so much pressure. So the laser's spinning around like this, and the hose is going, whoosh, whoosh, dry ice is going everywhere. My guitar is like almost frozen. You know what I mean? It wasn't all, you know, a smooth stream of success.
Once that you actually made a conscious decision to start writing songs that had uplifting, positive messages?
Well, this was right at this time, you know. There's always plenty of doom and gloom and unhappiness. And so I made a decision when I was, probably from the Joker on, that I was just going to concentrate on the more positive side of things. And I didn't want to be a Pollyanna about it. But, you know, I wanted to make music that was positive instead of negative. Because when I would get, I'd start writing and, you know, writing about problems or writing about this and writing about that, and I'd rapidly lose interest in what I was saying, you know. And if it was on a positive foot, I enjoyed it more, you know. And so when I sat down and I was working in Fly Like an Eagle and Book of Dreams and the Joker albums and writing all those songs, I had a goal to keep it, uplifting and musical and interesting. That's what I was trying to do.
That's how you feel about life, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
You know, feed the babies.
Yeah, you know, take care of problems, deal with things, and keep your head up and look to the future.